Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to WrestleMania.
Nobody knew exactly what to expect on March 31st, 1985. On this night, the industry stopped and held its collective breath. Would WrestleMania live up to the hype? Would sports entertainment, the flawless mixing of WWE superstars with other celebrities from music, film, and sport, prove to be a hit with the fans? Every man and woman who laced up a pair of boots that night was taking a leap of faith, knowing that they would sink or swim as the event did. With over 19,000 people in the legendary New York, in the history of WWE. Lucky for all of us, it was a success, and it formed the foundation for what is without a doubt the quintessential event of the year in sports entertainment. It has constantly grown, pushing the industry to the limits with every blockbuster encounter, every record broken, and then broken again. It's a destination, a fuel for the dreams that burn in those who hope to one day compete. Entire streaks have been built simply based on the results from that one event. Year after year, a simple point to a sign informs everyone that you're being challenged. Winning's always sweet. Winning a WWE championship is even sweeter. But for some reason, nothing can compare to standing tall on the grandest stage of them all. A Sunday night gathering at the arena has, over time, transformed into the monster two-day extravaganza that fills mammoth stadiums with people traveling from all over the world to be there. At WrestleMania, one will experience the highest of highs and the lowest of lows, all done in the name of chasing glory. I'm Corey Graves, and I'd like to welcome you to the WWE 2K24 Showcase of the Immortals. Here, we will spotlight some of the biggest, craziest, most jaw-dropping, action-packed matches in WWE history. It'll be on you to retrace the historical footsteps by way of our showcase objectives and lead these titans of industry to victory. This year, as WrestleMania turns 40, let's look back at the journey to get here together and relive some of the most memorable moments from WrestleMania's past. The first WrestleMania set the stage for everything that was to follow.
All the way around the world, now you know what it's all about, brother.
Celebrities were out in full force, showing that this was the place to be. WrestleMania 2 pushed the boundaries, taking place in three different locations, New York, Chicago, and Los Angeles, delivering three huge main events. But it would be WrestleMania 3 in 1987 that truly displayed WrestleMania's full potential. And for our first match of the 2K24 Showcase of the Immortals, we go into the first verified WrestleMania classic, the legendary clash for the WWE Intercontinental Championship between champion, the Macho Man Randy Savage, and his challenger, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Intercontinental Champion since February of 1986, Savage tore through anyone who challenged him. That included a successful defense against George the Animal Steele at WrestleMania 2. A clash between Savage and Steamboat during a late 1986 edition of Savage, a vicious attack on the Dragon after the match, taking him out of action. Savage would attempt to duplicate the attack on Steamboat's friend and former opponent, George Steele, during the first Saturday night's main event of 1987. Fortunately for the Animal, Ricky would make his well-timed return for the save, leading to the rematch between the two at WrestleMania. What transpired between the two combatants can only be described as art. A fast-paced, high-action classic unfolded in front of 90,000-plus in attendance, with both men coming so very close to victory on a number of occasions. Would Savage be able to turn back the challenge of his angry opponent? Would Ricky Steamboat get revenge? These questions would be answered over the next 15 grueling minutes, and when it was over, everyone in attendance and those watching at home knew they had been a part of something special. The two superstars would forever be etched in history following the match, with Ricky Steamboat finally putting an end to the Macho Man's historic reign.
Thank you.
It was all action from the moment the bell rang, dumping Steamboat back to the floor, letting you know that Savage understood he was in a fight unlike any other he'd been in before. Things were only getting started. The Macho Man was trying everything, and that included fighting dirty, but Steamboat The clash between the Dragon and the Macho after Steamboat was We still have Hulk Hogan against Andre the Giant. Featuring two of WWE's biggest stars at the time, this was the headliner that brought those 90,000 people together in the first place.
Everybody has their best day at WrestleMania. That's the creme de la creme. WrestleMania, main event, there's nothing else in this world like it.
Hulk Hogan and Andre the Giant were great friends for years. Andre famously poured the bubbly, and the two were nearly inseparable from then on. The two would be presented with trophies in separate weeks. Hogan was given one for reigning as champion for 3 years, while for both ceremonies, Andre was not his usual self, first noting to Hogan that 3 years to be a champion, it's a long time. And ultimately walking out of his own trophy celebration when Hogan arrived to praise Andre's accomplishments. The world was on edge, waiting to see what comes next. Soon after, Andre would appear with Bobby the Brain Heenan.
What, did you ever once in your life, offer him a championship match?
A heartbroken Hogan tried to reason with his friend, but with one move, there was no turning back.
There's nothing else like getting in the ring with Andre the Giant. It is the great unknown. When you get there and you're with Andre the Giant, you're outmatched, you're outsized, you're outpowered. It's an uphill battle, so you have to fight from underneath. You have to have everything in sync, body, mind, and soul, to survive fighting an opponent like Andre the Giant. When I slammed Andre the Giant, I was surprised how the crowd reacted. 94,000 people lost their breath and gasped at the same time. It overwhelmed me in the ring. It's etched in stone. It's just overwhelming how many people every day approach me and talk about WrestleMania 3.
Now it's up to you to do the impossible and defeat Andre the Giant at WrestleMania 3. It truly is the irresistible force meeting the immovable object. It felt like time stood still once the bell rang, and Hogan and Andre approached each other in the center of the ring. It was finally here, the reason all these people were in the arena. The dominant three-year WWE champion losing the match in the process. Could Hogan slam Andre? Would he try it again? Did he hurt his back or his knees in that failed lift? Andre, thinking he'd won the match, would have to recompose and get back on the task of taking out the Hulkster. Thank you.
baby.
Andre easily backdropped him to the floor. If Andre could shake off headbutting the ring post so quickly, what was it going to take to keep him down for a three count? Hulkamania was looking to be in deep, deep trouble. That moment where WWE history, Hogan was in full control of this match. And WrestleMania 3 ends with Real American blasting, a Hulk Hogan pose down, and Andre the Giant and Bobby Heenan, important matches not only in WrestleMania history, but WWE history itself. Up next, we jump ahead to WrestleMania 5 in Atlantic City, New Jersey. Those with tickets didn't know it as they entered the venue that evening, but they were about to witness one of WrestleMania's biggest upsets take place right in front of their eyes. The Ultimate Warrior captured the WWE Intercontinental Championship at the inaugural SummerSlam in 1988 by blitzing the Honky Tonk Man, ending his record reign in a little over 30 seconds. Since then, he seemed unstoppable, a lock to become WWE Champion one day. Two people who were not impressed were ravishing Rick Rude and his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. The 1987 Slammy Award winner for Best Body felt that Warrior was nothing special, both in-ring and even in terms of physique. This led to Rude challenging Warrior to a super pose down at the 1989 Royal Rumble, where the winner would be decided by the WWE Universe's approval. Pretty quickly, it was clear that the Ultimate Warrior was going to be crowned the People's Choice, and Rude was livid. It launched a vicious attack, bringing the competition to an abrupt end. That would lead to the signing of the contract for the two to compete in the Intercontinental Championship match at WrestleMania 5, and the world felt that Warrior would destroy his brash challenger. Heenan was desperate to have WWE gold in his vaunted Heenan family ranks, and he knew that the Ravishing One was the right man for the job. They told anyone who'd listen that Rude was going to beat the Ultimate Warrior at WrestleMania, and now the time had come. Had they backed Warrior into a corner, or were they about to realize they'd bitten off far more than they could chew? That's a question only you can answer. Warrior wasted no had steamrolled his challenger in the opening moments. Come on.
direct the attack. Big time ring awareness shown by the Ravishing One to keep himself in the match. Rude needed to take advantage here because his opportunities for offense were few and far between.
Thank you.
Rude looked to put Warrior away with the Rude Awakening. And then Warrior just powers out of it.
With a little assist from his manager, The Brain. Hey, if the ref doesn't see it, he can't call it. Those are the breaks. With the crowd buzzing from the monumental upset, it was time for WrestleMania 5 to deliver its main event. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, defending the WWE Championship against his former best friend and Mega Powers partner, Hulk Hogan.
Yeah, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Dig it.
He was one of a kind. He was intense. He was a great athlete. Everything about him was 100% perfect for sports entertainment and professional wrestling.
While the split of the Mega Powers was made official on a February 1989 edition of the main event, the cracks had been obvious to many long before that fateful night. Hogan and Savage's friendship had been beneficial to both, which was never more evident than the year prior at WrestleMania 4. On this evening, the vacant WWE Championship was to be decided in a 16-man, one-night tournament. In an absolutely brilliant display of athleticism and heart, the Macho Man would compete in 4 different matches to claim the championship. But it was in the final against the Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase that Savage would run into seemingly more trouble than he could handle. In DiBiase's corner was Andre the Giant. Throughout the match, Andre interjected, bringing Savage's offense to a halt, or distracting him for attacks by DiBiase. Eventually, Miss Elizabeth would run into the back, bringing Hogan out to restore some order. And Hogan's presence led to Savage's win with a perfectly timed chair shot that the ref didn't catch. Like I said before, those are the breaks. The Mega Powers would be locked in a heated rivalry with Andre and DiBiase, now known as the Mega Bucks, that culminated with their victory at the very first SummerSlam. Around this time, though, it appeared Randy Savage was jealous of the closeness between Hogan and Elizabeth. Some on commentary would mention it, but many were quick to dismiss that there was any tension between the two. Things got worse at the 1989 Royal Rumble when Hogan eliminated Savage, some claim accidentally, which infuriated the Macho Man. Everything came to a head at the main event 2 on February 3rd, 1989. The Mega Powers would compete in tag team action, looking to show the bond was still strong. After Miss Elizabeth was caught up in the action, Hogan would take her to the back for medical attention, leaving the Macho Man alone. Upon his
had slowed things down, looking to restore some order. The Macho Man's action sent a clear message that anything goes and anyone would be fair game.
Thank you. 2, 3. 1.